Speech secrets.
Speech secrets. We stayed with the water over here at the moment and talked with the people for them over there.
In today's video, we're talking about aphasia, a language disorder that affects communication. We'll focus on two major types, Wernicke's aphasia and Broca's aphasia. You'll see individuals with each type, and I'll break down how damage to specific areas of the brain can impact talking and understanding. Aphasia often occurs after a stroke or brain injury when the left side of the brain is damaged, specifically the temporal lobe or the frontal lobe. It can also occur with a brain tumor or with the degenerative disease primary progressive aphasia. Aphasia has subtypes based on if talking or understanding spoken language is more impaired. We call that a expressive or receptive aphasia. It's then further broken down by subtypes based on if speech is fluent or non-fluent. Which brings us to Mike. Mike has Broca's aphasia.
It's hard. Well, it's speech that's like words that don't understand. Brain is good. I don't know. It's like words, yuck.
Broca's aphasia is considered a non-fluent subtype. People generally understand language, but producing speech can be very effortful. They typically leave out shorter words like the, is, or a, using what we call telegraphic speech. This is caused by damage to Broca's area, which is in the posterior portion of the left frontal lobe. Broca's area is named after the French doctor Pierre-Paul Broca, who discovered the area in 1861. Let's meet someone with Wernicke's aphasia.
We stayed with the water over here at the moment and talked with the people for them over there. They're diving for them at the moment. They'll save him at the moment. He'll have water very soon for him. With luck for him.
You probably noticed his speech is fluent, but the words don't quite make sense. People with Wernicke's aphasia also have trouble understanding language and sometimes aren't aware that they have trouble understanding the language. Wernicke's aphasia is caused by damage to Wernicke's area, which is in the posterior temporal lobe. Wernicke's area was discovered by Carl Wernicke in 1874, and this area holds the auditory cortex responsible for understanding language. Our language centers are generally stored in the left hemisphere, but fun fact, damage to the right hemisphere can cause aphasia, in particular with individuals who are left-handed. However, about 95% of us are left hemisphere dominant, so it's still relatively rare. Aphasia can affect all areas of language: speaking, understanding, reading, and writing. People with aphasia know what they want to say, but can't often get the words out. Even though language is impaired with someone with aphasia, intelligence is often unaffected. Speech therapists identify the type of aphasia someone has to help guide rehabilitation and identify strategies for communication. If you learned something new today, drop a comment below. And as always, be kind to yourself.